Steve Dotto here, and as usual, I'm thrilled you're joining me for this demo. Today, let's talk about browser extensions. Specifically, in this case, we'll look at Chrome extensions, but if you choose to use a different browser, almost all of these extensions are going to be available in your browser as well. What am I talking about as far as browser extensions? Well, those are little bits of code that we plug into our browser that extend its functionality. And we typically find our browser extensions somewhere in the menu bar. So in this particular case, I'm using the Chrome browser from Google, and these are my extensions that I see up here that I can gain access to. And I wanted to show you, I think, five essential ones that you really should be using and probably don't know about. So we're going to start with one called Measure It, one of the simplest little tools. Anybody who ever has to do any work online is always, especially if they're doing any web development or even simply developing a page or now even doing Facebook posts on Facebook pages, you're often concerned about the size of your graphics and you want to know what works best. This tool here called Measure It is one that I use all the time. When I click on Measure It, it changes the screen in Chrome. You can't see the strange book change, but what it does is it converts your cursor into a crosshair, allowing you to measure any graphic that you see or any space that you see. So if you wanted to create another graphic, if you were working on something like this and you said, I want to create a graphic just like that, you know that that's 172 pixels by 33 pixels. How big is this little, if I was going to do a graphic and I was going to drop it into this notebook screen, how big should that graphic be? About 136 by 147. Really simple, really useful. It's an on and off toggle. Turn it off, it's gone. Turn it on, measure an area. Say, I'd like to put a graphic into that area. I'm going to need some about 275 by 275. Done. Okay, that is Measure It, and you can find it here at the Chrome Store, free. The next one I want to talk about is one that I've talked about a lot in the past, but is worth talking about on an ongoing basis. It's LastPass. It is one of the best security tools on the planet. And there's a couple of commercial tools that you can spend a little bit more money on and use that are just as good. But LastPass is free, so a lot of people will use it that might not spend the money in other areas. It's a password generator and management tool. So what it does is it helps us create those super high-end encrypted passwords that allow us to get into accounts, protect our security, but it also creates an access system so that we can easily recall those if we give it proper credentials. So all of your online banking, all of the different sites that you go to, instead of using the same password over and over again, which I know a lot of you do, you can instead use LastPass. It creates uber encrypted passwords that you'll never remember, but you don't have to remember because it stores them for you. You have one master password that gets you in, and once you've logged on and you're trusted, it automatically fills those passwords in, so it makes your web browsing experience going to different accounts that much more pleasant. LastPass is a great tool. Again, it's free. You can just go to LastPass and you can see all of their different products. They've got a premium one that's $12 a year. That gives you LastPass on your iPhone. That's as much as you could spend with the folks at LastPass. The next one that I want to show is a brand new tool, and it's from my friends at HootSuite, and it is the HootSuite Hootlet, which is a simple little tool that plugs into your browser that allows you to quickly take any page and tweet it out. And it ties into your HootSuite media dashboard, allowing you to access it. It creates a link to whatever page you're on, because that's probably what you want to share, and it creates a shortened Ollie link for it, but it allows you access to all of the scheduling tools and that sort of stuff that's within HootSuite, as well as allowing you access to all of your different accounts. The next tool that I want to show you is another one that's really more for web designers or people that have to do work online. Similar to Measure It, we often want to know what colors are being used so that we can recreate those colors and create some matching materials. This tool here called ColorZilla is an extension that allows you to pick the colors and actually to research what colors are being used on any one page. So I'm going to go to a page that has a little bit more color. Let's go back to that LastPass page here. And I'm going to click on ColorZilla, the color picker from my menu. And it allows me to pick a color from the page using a cursor to be able to pick a specific color. It also allows me to do something really cool here, which is analyze the different colors on a page. Let's do that before we do the color picking. So I click on the analyze, and what it does is it goes through. Now it's not looking at the it's not looking at it like it's a photo. Instead, it's looking into the CSS code. It's looking into the what the designers are using for the different elements on the page. So this is effectively the palette that's being used by the designers for this page. Now this can be really useful, and it shows us all of the different RGB values and all the values for each of the colors. So that's a great way to see exactly what colors. If you like the look of a page, it allows you to take a look and see the color palette that's being used by those designers. It's a great way to learn what good designers are doing and then help improve your design. If you just need a single color, what we do is we click on the pick color from page. Now this is a little bit tricky because you're not exactly sure it's working all of the time, because when you move your cursor out, you don't see anything. But you can see here that we actually have a dialog box that is giving us some information. So now when I do click, if I want to get that orange there, I click there and it copies the color to the clipboard. It allows me to do it. If we go back in here into the color picker and choose the color picker, we see the hex value and we also see the RGB value for that particular color. Now, one trick that you have to learn is when you click the and clip the color, it actually includes the pound key or the number sign in there as far as the color goes. So if you actually want to copy this and say use this color in Photoshop or anything else, you should actually copy it here from this dialog box, because you just need the hex code if you're going to copy it in into the color picker there. I'll just jump over into Photoshop. That if I wanted to take that color and then paste it, I can then do it this way here. Now we've got that color and we can use it in whatever graphic or whatever we're dealing with ourselves. So that's a very cool one called Color Picker. ColorZilla, excuse me. The last one is a simple little dictionary tool. If you're reading the news and there you're finding that there's words you don't always understand, the dictionary tool here that's available from the Google Chrome Store allows you to use Google Dictionary, and all it does is it creates an environment where you highlight any word on a page. So let's just go to our website here. We'll go to Dotto Tech, and I'll go into an article that might have some very, very confusing words in. And maybe I have used too big a words in this article. Maybe the word journalist is confusing to you. I know the definition of journalist might have changed a lot. So basically, any word that you go into and you just double click on it in the document, you don't have to even enable the tool here, it pops up with a little bit of a description. If you click on more, it'll take you back into the Google Dictionary. Frustrated. What's the word frustrated mean? Oops, double click. There it is. Feeling or expressing distress. An annoyance, especially because of the inability to change or achieve something. Indeed, that does describe frustration to me. So there you have it. We have one, two. We have Measure It, LastPass, Hootlet, Color Picker, and Google Dictionary. Five essential Chrome add-ons that you can use and will make your day all that much better. I hope you found this video useful. If you have, please give us a thumbs up, give us a like. We love getting compliments from you. That's what really the juice that keeps us going. I'm Steve Dotto. We'll see you again next week.